Hey guys, how you doing? JP Saricolia here. I hope you're having a fantastic day. Now, yesterday was an amazing day for Star Wars fans. There were a lot of stuff that was revealed, a lot of collectibles that went on pre-order. Some stuff is still going on pre-order in the next couple of days. So it is a time for us to really pay attention to everything that is coming because there's a lot of cool stuff. Now, in this video today, I want to cover a couple of companies that they released some stuff yesterday. We have Gentle Giant. They released a couple of minibus that look amazing. Regal Robot is releasing a Holo Chest, the Jarrick Holo Chest set that has a lot of people talking. And we have also Royal Selangor releasing a Mandalorian Pewter statue, very cool statue. And Iron Studios finally is releasing the General Grievous statue that a lot of people are excited for because this is the thing they've been asking for this company to get into the Star Wars line. And first, we're here at Gentle Giant because I want to show you this minibus. As you can see, we have this Star Wars A New Hope Biggs Dark Lighter Rebel Pilot minibus. This is very cool. This is on the regular scale, the 1/6 scale that they normally produce. There's no edition size yet, and we don't know when this is going to be released. But I'm telling you, this is a very cool piece. If you're really into this line, you've been collecting that. A lot of people have been talking for this one or asking for this one for a while. Love the design. Not only is it really cool, the fact that it has interchangeable parts, as you can see, an interchangeable head and arms, and also he's carrying that helmet. I love what they're doing right now with this interchangeable parts. I think Gentle Giant is really doing great with that, and he's also holding his gloves. Really cool. Now, some people may not like the fact that you can see the seams there, but in my opinion, I think they did a good job in kind of hiding it, although it's a bit visible. So maybe they need to kind of soften the lines here a little bit, so it doesn't look as, you know, as a plastic toy in some ways. But it's really cool. I think the paint job on the prototype is good. Very cool, the cold concept. And definitely a lot of fans that were asking for this one are going to be very happy about it. So really cool. Like the concept. The paint job is good. Definitely love the interchangeable parts. Now we're moving on to the Star Wars The Bad Batch Wrecker Minibus 2021 web exclusive. There's actually two different versions, a regular and this exclusive. The price is the same, $99.99, $100. The scale is 1/7, so in some ways, I'm not necessarily comfortable with the price. I think this should be more like a $79, $89. The edition size is 1,000 for the exclusive, and for the regular, it's going to be 3,000 pieces. Now, one thing about this is that the scale is 1/7 in this type of minibus, so it's not going to really pair with the other, you know, the classic Gentle Giant Star Wars minibus collection. They're very similar to like Bowen minibus, so it's kind of in the same scale. So some people may not like that. The exclusive has the two interchangeable portraits with the helmet. The regular doesn't have it, but this is what the regular has. I like it. I do like this, and I haven't even watched the first episode yet, and I'm going to do it this weekend. I'm really looking forward to the show and to, you know, to watch it all and review it in the channel. I really like the last season of the Clone Wars and the introduction of these characters. But I like it. I think they did a good job. The painter did a good job. Love the detail everywhere around and everything. It looks a bit cartoony, but I think it's just to resemble, in that case, the 3D animation. And I like that. The only thing I would complain again is just the fact that it's a 1/7 instead of being a 1/6. All right, then now we're moving on to Regal Robot Collectibles. And for that reason, I'm here at SciShow because they're the ones selling this product. And I'm telling you, this is something that I'm so surprised. Because they're selling this Holo Chest pieces, and this is something that if you watch the channel of Adam Savage Tested, a few years ago he interviewed the people involved in the production of the marionettes that were used in the film and start in the original trilogy for this Holo Chest pieces. But these pieces are a technical replica of those originals that, you know, they were made out of rubber and they pretty much disintegrated. So they decided to 3D printed this, and these are made out of silicone. So a few years ago, they produced this new replicas, amazing looking replicas. So this company is pretty much reproducing that work, and they really selling it in a very limited quantity. That's the reason they're really expensive, and a lot of people are not going to go for it. But ultimately, I'm telling you, there are a lot of people out there willing to pay the price, because as you can see, the deluxe signature edition, which is only limited to 70 pieces, is already sold out, and the price was $5,000, $5,000, which is amazing. Now, this is the whole set, you know, and there are differences. You can buy things separately, But you cannot buy, for example, the main characters here, this tall guy and this guy that looks like a monkey with the hammer, they have different poses on the separate set. So this pose is just only for the set. And these two pieces right here, this one right here that you can see, the green one and the red one in the back, those are only exclusive to the set. So if you want to have them all, you have to have the set, which is unfortunate if you didn't get the chance for it. Now, would I pay $5,000 for something like this? Definitely not. I would definitely save the money for something else. But being the case that it's super limited, and you can see the signature of the creators, the people that were involved actually with Lucasfilm, they are the guys that they did this and they had to reproduce this again. They're the ones signing this, and it is a collector's item for sure, and it's not for everyone, but definitely the hardcore Star Wars fan is going to love this. Now, these are only exclusive, again, to the Signature Edition, and here you have the plaque with Dennis Murren and John Burke and Phil Tippett. Now, if you miss on the Lost Signature Edition, you can still purchase the separate sets, although, you know, you're going to miss two pieces there. And again, the Mantillian Saber and the Kintar Strider, which they call the Body Slam set, the pose is very different, as you can see right here. It's different. It's a Body Slam. I like it. It is different. And yeah, but yeah, this one is $1,300. The other ones are $900, of course, plus shipping. A lot of money for sure. And not necessarily something that I would feel comfortable paying, but I know some people will. And the fact that this is already waitlisted tells you that there's people out there willing to pay the price. All right, guys, now we're moving on to Royal Selangor. Here also at SciShow, we have this, the Mandalorian. There's a gilt version, there is a silver version, and we also have this Grogu limited edition, very small figurine. And it is pricey though. It is $160 for the gilt version and $95 for the silver version. Those are really nice companion. Let me show you, so it gives you an idea of the size. You want like a little gift to give to someone, I think these are perfect. I love this silver one, and it's the cheapest, but also the gilt one, if you want something a little more premium, kind of looks like gold, and it's almost sold out. And the edition for this is 1,000. The other one does it's an open edition size. But here you can see, very tiny, very small. I think it's a very nice gift to give to your spouse. I definitely, something that I will give to my wife or my daughter. They really love Grogu. But I want to talk about today about the Mandalorian. This is the gilt version, $720, only 300 pieces. It's going to release between July and September of this year. Very cool. It looks a bit cartoony. I like that. I do like the design, and the pose is fine. I think the base is simple. I'm sure it's heavy. It's a deserted terrain, some type of moon. Really cool. But I like it. I think the gilt version always, again, the gilt versions are all more expensive. You can see the number right here in the back. I wish it had a bit, some type of design or logo at the front. That would have been nicer, in my opinion. I want to show you the silver version. The price is $490, close to $500. The editions is 1,500 pieces, and it's going to release around the same time, July and September. To be honest with you, I prefer this version. I think the color works best with the Beskar armor and all of that. I think it's better. Detail looks clearer than even with the gilt version. Normally the gilt versions, because of the golden color and the coloration and the metal, it tends to show you more detail. I feel in this case, for this particular design, it is better like this. And it's cheaper. So I would say go for this one. It is the same design, same sculpt, no difference, but I have the same criticism for this one as I do with the gilt version. There's no Mandalorian sign in the front. I think it would have been very nice to have the title here. And finally, we're coming to Iron Studios, and we're still here at SciShow because they're the ones that hold the license for Star Wars products here in North America. And the General Grievous Deluxe, a 1/10 scale statue. And it is exciting because a lot of people were anticipating the Star Wars line to, you know, to come to the 1/10 BDSR scale. And it is really good to see this. And definitely it is interesting that they went for General Grievous as the first piece in this collection. $365. A lot of people are not excited about that. This is going to release on between January and March of next year. I think they chose a really nice pose of General Grievous. And another thing I would say, it has mixed media, and a lot of people don't like that, but I understand what they were trying to do. I feel that doing this cape is the best way to do it because it's also removable, and there's no better option you cannot really go with a full cape, a sculpted cape, because it's going to be really hard to remove it. So I think they made the best choice, not necessarily the choice that everyone wants. But I like the whole terrain, everything, of course, based on the trilogy, on that particular trilogy with the clones. The material that they're using here, for what I can see, looks okay. It looks better than some of the material that Sideshow uses. And I'm just basing that on the picture alone. I don't really know in the end. And my concern or my desire is for this to be of better quality of what normally Sideshow produces, because in the end, that's what you want. You want something that can stand for a while, that can survive any type of damage, you know, all the situations that we have to deal with humidity, the heat, all of that. But the pose is good. Too bad it doesn't have light of features. But at this price point, you know, it's understandable. At the same time, some people will say that's too expensive for a 110. But keep in mind, sometimes this is the thing, and I said it many times before, people get so bogged down with the idea of scale that they forget dimensions. Dimensions are the first thing that you got to think, not only the scale, but dimensions. If this is really big, taller, and wider, then definitely it's going to cost more money to produce. It's going to cost more money just to transport as well. All of that is tabulated into the final price. Not saying that Iron Studios is doing great with the pricing. I mentioned that yesterday on my video when I was talking about other stuff that Iron Studios is doing, also with the orcs, with the Lord of the Rings, that I'm not really comfortable with the pricing that they're coming up with. And they have to really rethink the strategy. So if they want to keep customers happy, particularly when they're not really releasing edition sizes, they're not giving you that information. So we don't know how many they're producing. They can produce thousands upon thousands and nobody really knows. So are they really collectible? So that's the part where people have to, you know, they voice their opinion in many ways. It's understandable. But yeah, I like the design. Definitely they did a good job there with the cape. Now without the cape, really cool. Very cool. He's skinny, but you know, it's based on the character. And I love the paint job. Whoever did the paint job here, you see all the stains and all of that. It's so accurate. I like this one. Really good. It's a nice job. They did a good job on this one. Love the detail. Definitely with that cape looks more premium. Without it also looks great. And I'm really looking forward to see what this company is going to produce. I want to see more of these characters. Definitely, I want to see. And one thing is true is that Iron Studios is the king of the 110. And they have this dynamic poses. Look at this. Now, in reference with the guy in the back, yeah, the statue is big. This guy is not small. I can see that. He's not small. And the piece is big. So, you know, 13 inches in height, that's pretty good. The width is 15 by 7, 9.8. So you have to think that it's going to, you know, have, you know, some, the box is going to be bigger than normal. So, yeah, all of those things are facts that need to be measured when you are adding the price. So I'm telling you, I love the stuff that we are getting. You know, there's so much stuff out there. It's amazing. You can turn into any page of any of these companies every single day. I come to Sideshow every day. I have to look at the stuff they're producing and they're selling and for other producers. It's amazing. We are living in amazing times, and there's something for everyone. And yes, you know, sometimes the price point is really up there, and not everyone can afford everything. If I was a millionaire, definitely I would buy so much stuff, so much junk I would put in my house. My wife would kill me. But ultimately, I feel that there's a lot of cool stuff that really touches the senses. And it's amazing to see what, you know, the fan base out there willing to pay the price for these pieces. But what is your opinion, my friends? What do you think about the pieces that we covered today? What do you think about the Bad Batch Mini Buzz by Gentle Giant? What do you think about Regal Robots, the Hollow Chest set? Are you okay with the price? What do you think about the Mandalorian by Royal Selangor? And what do you think about Iron Studios now getting into Star Wars? Let me know in the comments below. So once again, my friends, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, to comment, and to subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification button so you're reminded of the next video. Follow me on social media. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, the links are down below. And please consider supporting the channel financially through Patreon. My friends, God bless you. Take care, and I will talk to you again. Bye-bye.